Okay, so I will continue with my lectures now, so sinisingil na nila ako. Okay, so let's proceed with problem number 19. So since wala kayo makikita problems, I will just read it, no? Okay, the problem number 19 states that what is the equation of the line passing through 3 and 0 and 0 and negative 2? Determine daw the equation of line. Okay, bonus na lang na. So, go to ito para mas madali ito. So, go to mode 3 to. Okay. And then, for mode 3 to, kasi, as you can see, in your mode 3 to, meron yung mga iba't ibang equation. Your first equation is getting the variance. So, you have just one data. Ang number 2 is a linear relationship. So therefore, you have an equation. Kaya mapansin mo, a plus bx, that is actually y is equals to a plus bx. So since we are to solve for one equation, given 2 points, so therefore, we go to second one. Kasi yung third mo is actually the second plus cx squared. So yung number 3 is the quadratic equation. So mode 3 to, then go to 2. So pag press mo lang 2, you have x and y. So meaning, ana, that is just actually points. So for one equation with two unknown, so therefore we need 2 points to determine our equation. So therefore, i-type in na nato ni, okay, you have your x and y. So here first, if your x is 3, your y is 0. If your x is 0, your y is negative 2. Type lang yung sa calculo, 3, then 0, then you have 0 and negative 2. Okay, your equation here will become y is equals to a plus bx. Oh, yan yung actually nakita mo kanina, di ba? So therefore, if we get A, then we get B, therefore we can get the equation. So we will solve that A. To get A, that is actually shift plus 1, kasi naka-start mode ka. Exit ka muna pala, ha? I-exit nyo muna. Then go to shift 1, ganun pa rin. Shift 1, ayan, go to 5 for regression. Meaning sa 5, regression, mga values yan. Okay, mga relationship. Okay, regression values. Okay, you get your y, you get your x, you get your a, you get your b. Kaya ito nakikita natin. So, a is number 1. Kaya, therefore, just press 1 and press equals, you get negative 2. And for your b, the same procedure. Copy ka lang, pero instead nga 1, that is actually in number 2. So therefore, you have your 5, 2. So therefore, you have point something. So press ka lang itong SND to get the fraction. Okay, that is actually 2/3. So therefore, your equation of the line, dito ko na sulat kasi nahirapan ako dahil sa tripod. So therefore, you have the equation of the line y is equal to negative 2 plus 2/3 x. You can actually work this out, but actually this is already in the standard form. Okay? This is actually the implicit form. You have now your answer. Ayan. Mas mandi lang, no? Kasi gagamit ka na for conventional method, gamitin mo si slope two forms. Pwede din si slope form to get the equation, but ito yung pinakamadali for me. Okay, kahit anong calculator, you can do this one, ha? Kahit yung inaalaw lang na brand na calculator ni Casio sa board exam, you can actually still get this or do this. Okay, so let's proceed with problem number 20. So, your problem number 20 states that what is the equation of the line that passes through 2 and 2 are perpendicular to the line x plus 2y is equal to 4. Okay, also you can use the calculator here. But since this is very obvious, mas madali kasi ito pag conventional. To do this one, you have 2y. is equal to negative x plus 4. Divide natin sa 2. Divide natin sa 2. Therefore, you have your y is equal to negative x all over 2 plus 2. Concern ko lang naman si slope. Ang slope nito is negative 1 half. Okay, to get the perpendicular line, ang slope niya will be the perpendicular line. M of the perpendicular line is equal to the negative negative reciprocal of the given line, the perpendicular lines. Because the product of their slope is equal to negative 1. Therefore, my slope of the perpendicular is equal to positive 2. Madal naman yan, di ba? Okay. So if I have here the slope, okay, general form, you have mx plus b. So substitute na lang natin, you have your 1 point and a slope, so therefore your 1 point is 2, is equal to 2 times 2 plus b, so therefore you have 2, is equal to 4 plus b, so therefore your b is equal to how much? Negative 2. So therefore your equation is equal to y is equal to 2x minus 2. So this will be your equation of the line. Okay? Dali ka na. Grade 1. Okay, that's problem number 20. So let's proceed with problem number 21. Okay, given the vertices of the triangle, given the vertices of triangle, now you have A, 2, sorry, this is 3 halves, and 3 and 2 rather. B is 5 and 5, and C is 4 and negative 3. Find the distance of point B from side AC. Okay? Distance down A, point B. Ay, okay, so if we are given a triangle lang itong grapa, therefore 1, 2, 3, and 2, nandito si A, si B mo is 5, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, so 3, 4, 5, nandito si B, then si C ko is kalayo-layo ba? 3 na 4, then 1, 2, 3, dito. And ito si C. Now, ang tinatanong actually, is find the distance ni B daw to side AC. Uy, ito pala yung nanap niya. Perpendicular distance, ha? Perpendicular distance. Okay. So, dapat 90 degrees na to get the distance. Okay. So, ito hinanap. Uy, di ba we have a formula for our distance of the line? Distance from a point, you have your AX plus BY plus C all over the positive or negative square root of A squared plus B squared. Tama? So therefore, we need a point and we need the equation of the line. Kasi this is the equation of the line. Okay, how to use this one? This is actually A. A is, where A, B, C are values of coefficient from the equation of line. And your x and y are actually a point. Are points. Okay? So therefore, I need the points. So meron naman akong point ni B, di ba? Kailangan ko na lang is the equation ni AC. Uy, pero kanina, di ba nasolve na to how to get the equation? Mas mabilisan. Okay. To get the equation, okay, alam ko naman yan, pinakita ko lang yung graph. Okay, para makita nila. But in reality or in during the actual examination, hindi naman kailangan i-draw yan. No? So, i-resign ko na lang. Pinakita ko lang. So, ganito mangyayari. You have your AB. And actually, the positive and negative, the distance, pag positive, it means that the point is above the line. Pag negative, the point is below the line. So, paano mag-determine? Kasi hindi mo naman kailangan i-draw siya. So, So, ang technique niyan, kung ano ang value ni B mo, kung positive ba or negative, yan yung magiging sign mo dito. Yan yung magiging sign mo sa baba. Okay? So, example. Example na natin, ha? O, meron naman akong point B sa angin na equation ni line AC. But I know, but I am given 2 points. O, yung ginawa natin kanina, go to mode 3, 2. Okay? Mode 3, 2. Kaya therefore, you have your x and y. Input tayo when x is... Kaya meron kayo x and y. X is 3, y is 2. X is 4, y is negative 3. Okay? 3, 4. Then sa kabila, 2 and negative 3. The same procedure. Kaya therefore, you have y is equal to mode 1, 5. Then solve for a. Our a is equal to 17. Our b is equal to... negative 5. So therefore, our equation is equals to is equals to 17 minus 5x. Okay? So based from this, gagawin muna natin itong general equation to get a, b, and c. So in general equation, our form is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So that will be our form, ha? So ax, you have 5x at sa kabila, plus y minus 17 is equal to 0. So therefore, my a here is equal to 5, my b here is equal to 1, and my c is equal to negative 17. Okay? So substituting now from the equation, mabilisan na lang yan. So your distance now is equal to your a is pila? 5. Your x, ang point mo dito is the 5 and 5, therefore you have 5. Plus your b is 1 times 5. Plus your c, you have negative 17 all over positive, kasi positive siya, square root of, you have square lang ito, you have 5 squared plus 1 squared. So therefore, your d is equals to how much? Okay, you have 5 times 5 plus 1 times 5 plus negative 17 all over square root of 5 squared plus 1 squared. So therefore, the distance is equals to 2.55. Okay, and this will now be your answer. Okay? Ayan. So, 20. Number 20, ano? Okay, number 20 yan. So, how about problem number 22? Okay, so the same. We are tasked to determine the area. Okay. The same figure, hanapin ko daw si area ni triangle. Conventionally, ang gagawin nyo siguro, no? Kaya kukunin nyo si distance, which is okay. Then, mag-inherence formula kayo. Okay lang naman, pero I will be teaching you another technique. Okay. So, we can actually use this one in your calculator using mode 3, 2 pa rin. Go to mode 3 to solve this one. But ang rule ani, kailangan ako naka-arrange. Meaning, naka-arrange siya from left to right. Diba, galing na sa figure. Andito si A, andito si B, andito si C. So, dapat, pagsulat na ito ni, dapat, kabalo ka sa flow ba? Una din si A, B, or C, or pwedeng paana. As long as alam mo ang pagkasunod-sunod nila. Based on vertices. Bawat ang A, okay na kasi ito for 3 triangles kasi tatlo. Pag kasi magamit mo itong technique na ito for a square or any rectangular rectangular shapes or any shapes. Pwede actually dito. So kung rectangle ka, dapat nakapasunod ang imong points. You have A, B, C, and D. Bawal ka magpass. Okay? Mag-bypass na A, C, tas D, B. O, bawal yan. Ang rule dito, dapat naka-arrange ang points mo according to this rotation. Or pwede yung pakabila. Basta pasunod. O, yun lang yung point ko. Okay? So, basically, alam ko naman na nakapasunod na ito, no? So, therefore, the arrangement of this is you have 3 and 2. Next is 5 and 5. Then, 4 and negative 3. And I know this is my x and this is my y. Okay? So, to get the area of that, you go to mode 3 to, ganito yung rule. Okay? Copy first all the values.